Hi there! So today I would like to share with you what is Commitlint and how to use it. As you have seen before, we have tried to make a commit using this message. And here is where Commitlint comes in. On the output of this command we got. Here is your input, red text, and here is your two problems. First one is subject empty and type empty. As any smart developer, first thing we will do is go to this link in the error. So, what is Commitlint? Shortly, Commitlint is an NPM package which can validate any commit message or any string based on specified rules. By default, Commitlint proposes us to use conventional commit format. And here is some examples how it can look like. So following this pattern, commit should have three parts. First one is type of commit, second one is scope, which is optional, and third one is actually subject, or classic commit message. Let's start with types. According to the official Commitlint documentation on GitHub, they support 11 types. For better understanding, I have created a cheat sheet where you can see description for each type and see some quick examples. Link will be in the description. The second part of commit is the scope. Scope is optional parameter where you can put the area where you have made some changes on the codebase. It could be a fix on server side, it could be feature on blog, it could be some changes on catalog or whatever you want. Also, in some cases, you can use Jira ticket or any other ticket number as a scope. So for example, we can use NFID6 as a scope of this commit, because changes are only in scope of this ticket. So first case when you need it. It's when you want to increase your productivity inside a team, from turning your Git log looking from this into looking like this one. It's well structured, it has better readability, and it can increase performance of all of your collaborators. And the second advantage of conventional commits is ability to generate change logs. By having well-organized and structured commit messages, you can automatically generate pages like that on every release you have. Last thing I want to show you is how to set up Commitlint into your project. Actually, it shouldn't take more than 1 minute. If you will go to official Commitlint documentation on GitHub and scroll to Getting Started section, you can see a few steps how to integrate Commitlint into your project. So let's do it. Now we will go to the documentation and do the following actions. Firstly, we need to add Commitlint and needed dependencies to our project. After that, we will go back to the documentation and follow the next step. Here we go. And last thing we need is Husky. Husky is a tool which will run validation before each commit. It will just add a hook on this action. So firstly, we need to install Husky into our project. After that, we need to initialize Husky in our project. We can do it by this command. And after that, we can just add a hook to run Commitlint before each commit message. Here we go.